Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class again I will be dealing with the four editorials. Now first of all we have the lead editorial, and then we have the sub lead editorial, and then we have the left corner editorial, and then we have the bottom corner editorial. Now first of all let us start with the bottom corner editorial. Now this editorial relates to the election of new president of Iran. Now when it comes to the election of the new president of Iran, I have already discussed this in previous two classes. So from mains examination point of view, it is not important to discuss this editorial again. Now if you are interested to know more about this, the election of the new president of Iran, you can watch the previous editorial classes done by me. Now then we have the top corner, left corner editorial. Now this relates to the conviction of three bureaucratic officials in the coal scam case. Now from mains examination point of view, this is important. Then this is more important for the public administration optional students. Now as far as the bureaucracy is concerned, generally it is believed that the bureaucracy works on the principle of anonymity, and bureaucracy holds no responsibility of the decisions taken by it, because the ultimate responsibility in the parliamentary form of government lies mostly with the minister. So it is the bureaucracy theoretically which is not generally held responsible for the actions that they generally take. But as far as this specific case of coal scam is concerned, it is the bureaucracy, it is the three specific bureaucrats who have been convicted in this case of coal scam. So this editorial can be used as an example by the students of public administration optionals, that this is one specific case in the bureaucrats, in which the bureaucrats, they have been convicted by the court. Now then we have a sub-lead editorial. Now the sub-lead editorial is for the geography optional students, and this is also important from environment point of view. So this will help you in GS 1 and GS 3. Now this primarily relates to the waste water management, and this editorial discusses about how India has not designed effective policies, programs, laws in order to tackle this issue of wastewater management. So basically India needs to devise good policies, programs in order to tackle the problem of wastewater management. Now why this wastewater management is important for a nation like India? Now by 2030 the requirement of the clean drinking water will see a jump of 50%. So this jump of 50%, it's actually a very huge jump. So in order to cater to such a huge demand, a nation like India should actually devise good policies of this wastewater management. Now before we understand, or before we devise measures of this wastewater management, it is important to understand that how this entire waste water is being generated. Now firstly it is generated by the industry, secondly it is generated by the agriculture, and thirdly it is generated by the domestic sector of India. So this entire effluent water, that the entire nation is creating, it is troubling the ecosystem. It is creating a pressure on our ecosystem. So it becomes very, very important that India should come out with a concrete policy to tackle this wastewater management. Now, in order to read more on this wastewater management, more facts on the previous year policies of the government of India, you can download IAS Buzz app. In that specific app, we have added the topic on this wastewater management. So that will give you a better idea about the previous policies. Because if you're reading this topic, you must not only know about that how much would be the increase in the demand of the clean drinking water or how it is going to affect the environment ecology. You must also know certain things about the previous actions taken by government of India under Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, urban and Swachh Bharat Abhiyan rural, and certain rules with respect to waste disposal. Now then we have the lead editorial. Now this lead editorial primarily relates to International Court of Justice recent decision to stop the conviction, to put on hold the conviction on Kulbhushan Jadhav. Now this specific case of Kulbhushan Jadhav actually involves a lot of issues with respect to international diplomacy. Ye international diplomacy ka bahut bada issue ban gaya Kulbhushan Jadhav wala case. First of all, it involves the case that we have internationalized this entire issue of Kulbhushan Jadhav. Ab ek issue ko humne itna internationalize kar diya hai to iske repercussions bhi bahut ho sakte hain. Repercussions in the sense, now Pakistan can also try to internationalize the issue of Jammu and Kashmir. And India has never been in favor of internationalizing the Jammu and Kashmir issue. So J&K ke issue ko India kabhi bhi internationalize nahi karna chahta. So this is the first thing. Now the second thing discussed in this editorial is about what if the Pakistan will not obey to the orders of International Court of Justice. Now in the past we have certain examples and cases like that of United States of America. Now United States of America with respect to Mexico has taken such a retrograde step whereby it had convicted the persons of Mexico. The conviction, the execution of which was put on hold by the International Court of Justice. And there are chances that the Pakistan might also convict and execute Kulbhushan Jadhav. Now if the execution of the Kulbhushan Jadhav will take place, in that case, the relationship and the diplomacy between India and Pakistan will take a downturn. तो उस सिचुएशन में जो रिलेशन है जो डिप्लोमेसी है दोनों के बीच में वो काफी ज्यादा खराब हो जाएगी. सो दिस इज रियली गोइंग टू हैव एन इंपैक्ट ऑन द डिप्लोमेसी. सो इट इज अबाउट ओबेइंग इंटरनेशनल लॉ. इंटरनेशनल लॉ. सो द थर्ड इशू इज अबाउट द लेजिटिमेसी. लेजिटिमेसी ऑफ इंटरनेशनल लॉ. Now international law बहुत ज़्यादा important है. अभी international law is with respect to climatic change. Now international law is with respect to Vienna Convention, that how to treat the prisoners of war. Then we have this international law with respect to the division of the lands and the boundaries. We also have the international law with respect to sea boundary, that is United Nations Convention on the Law of Sea. But when it comes to the obeying of all these international laws are actually not obeyed, because the jurisprudence with respect to international law is very strengthened theoretically, but practically it don't have a relevancy, because we don't have a global government, we don't have the global strict architecture, structure and global police in order to implement the international laws. So India is actually harping a lot about this International Court of Justice verdict with respect to Kulbhushan Jadhav case. But it is also very important for a nation like India that should also obey the international laws and the treaties and the conventions. जो बहुत ज़्यादा domain में अभी women के लिए international treaties में India में बहुत कम implementation किया है. Human rights को लेके India में बहुत ज़्यादा international treaties है. India ने human rights को लेके उनकी implementation नहीं की है. So and also with respect to torture, and also with respect to the rights of the prisoners, also with respect to the rights of the women, also with respect to the right of the citizens, also with respect to the rights of the labor. So bahut zyada international treaties and conventions hai jo Hindustan ne khud implement nahi kiye. To agar Hindustan chahta hai ki international court of justice aur koi bhi international body kisi international convention ki provisions ko implement karaye, to India should also act as per conscience in order to implement the conventions and the treaties and the policies of such international conventions before just focusing and cherry picking one of the convention and making it implemented. ऐसा नहीं है कि एक को पकड़ के आप बोल दो कि इसको implement कर दो, बाकियों को implement नहीं करना है. तो इस तरह का जो अगर situation हिंदुस्तान create करता है, it actually hits at the value and the credibility of a nation like India. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice nice day. And do download this app called as IAS Buzz. Currently this app is available only on Android. But in the coming days, we will also be launching its iOS version. Bye bye, take care, have a nice nice day.